This has been a most requested video I've had in quite a while, and this is the Masashi Kudo's kind of expo interview that he had, or panel or booth, whatever you want to call it, at the Pacific Media Expo of 2016. Now, I do believe that this expo was in November or October, and I don't know why it took so long to surface the way it did, but Masashi Kudo, the director and the designer for the Bleach anime, basically the guy who you want to go to if you want to talk to about Bleach anime. And of course, you got the majority of the fans are asking him Bleach related questions because, well, that's his jig, and I'm disappointed for the fan base not asking him better questions, such as, well, why did Bleach end? Or why did they awkwardly place fillers at certain scenes? Now, these questions would have been nice. The only good question in this interview is, what do you think of Bleach now that it has ended, talking about the manga, which is probably the better question than, who is your favourite character and which do you prefer, Orihime or Rukia, because yes, people ask that question. And the dude's quite smart, because when someone asked him about who he preferred, Rukia or Orihime getting with Ichigo, he just said, he didn't want to answer that, which is fair play to him, because I would imagine he already saw the backlash of that whole ship war go down. But to get to the point of this, because I don't want to get anybody's hopes up, but I probably already have, and I probably have myself to some certain degree, is, well, what do you think of Bleach now that it has ended? And his response was, as a manga story, it has ended, but there are parts that haven't been made into anime yet. I talk a lot with the anime staff about things we can do later, and just like that, here, opened up a can of worms. One, for example, the person who asked this question didn't ask anything anime related, he just simply asked of, what does he think of Bleach now that it's ended? Masashi Kudo, in this respect, was the one that brought up the anime, saying, well, that there was parts that haven't made it into the anime yet, and we talk about them, about what we can do later on. Like, he was the one that brought up anime. Somebody just wanted to know what his thoughts were now that the manga's ended. So, of course, what does this tell me, and what does it tell you guys, is that the fact that he said later, I really don't want to say it. I can't believe the dude said later. Why would you say later? Like, if he said, oh, I talk to the staff on a regular basis about how cool it would be to add this in the anime if it were to come back, would be like, oh, okay, like, he obviously doesn't know, but what would you say later? Like, this is stuff we can add on later. Like, is there something you're not telling us? And the big misconception about the anime is that people think it was cancelled, or people think that it was ended, and there is actually no explanation on that at all. I think when the Bleach anime actually ended, it was only like 3 chapters into the Thousand Year Blood War arc, so it was either put one big massive filler into it, or put it on hiatus, which could still be the case. I could sit here for ages and try and deconstruct this sentence, but the dude was simply like, oh yeah, I talk to the anime staff all the time, and we talk about stuff we can do later on, which is cool, because I'm glad that they're still stuck as a team. That's what I really love about Bleach's team, is that they always work together, and they always know how to cooperate with each other, and that's what made the Bleach anime so great, is that you had this team of veterans just working alongside each other, and they understood each other. And I mean, to bring on past interviews that he's had on in the past with people asking him about the Bleach anime as well, which is cool, because every expo that this guy goes to, people are asking him about the anime, is the anime coming back, and he's not really given us an answer. He's always just said, we'll just make sure to support and just show that the Bleach fandom is still there, and you know, the anime may come back. And now he's saying, you know, later, like, nobody's asked, is the Bleach anime going to come back? But he kind of dug himself a hole, maybe. He kind of said it himself rather than being asked. He's rather like, oh yeah, we always discuss on what we can do later. Like, honestly, to me, I think Masashi Kudo does really want Bleach to come back. I think, like, he has tried to pitch it to Studio Perrier probably a lot of times. He's probably tried to show how much, like, the fandom is there waiting and willing for it. And honestly, I do believe that there's talks about it. I mean, why would Masashi Kudo go and talk to his staff members about what they could do later if it was a cancelled show, or if it ended, or there was no plans for production? Well, why? It just seems like a pointless thing to bring up. And I do think that he may have slipped up in this case. And maybe that's why he does attend these expos. Maybe in a way of, yeah, like, he gets to speak and see some of the fans. But as well, maybe Perrier allow him to go to these expos so they can relay, oh, is Bleach still a thing? Is the West still a big fan of Bleach? Maybe it is some kind of weird market research on sending Kudo over there to see if there is a fan base over for them to be viable to create the anime. I don't know. I'm just spouting shit, and I don't know how to feel about this. The guy guy just said later, like, I talked to my people later about it, about what we could possibly do, and they're constantly talking about it, like, they're constantly having conversations about the Bleach anime, and I love it. I really do. And I don't want to get people's hopes up, but the guy literally shot himself in the fucking foot here, and I just, no. Honest to God, I'm just in so much hope right now. I do think that, you know, as much as we talk about the Bleach anime, as much as I make videos on it, that the more attention we bring to the topic, the more it will get noticed, at least by somebody at some point. If you want something in this world, you gotta shout and make it known that you want it. And make these studios know, or make these individuals know, that there is a market for it and people do want it, and that's how business works. All it takes is for one person to see the fan base, see the screams and cries of fans, to make something happen. And if we can keep doing that, if we can keep pushing and fighting for this anime, then I'm telling you, we will get it. Eventually, it will happen. As long as we keep showing love and support, and we keep buying it, we keep buying the Blu-ray box sets, we keep buying the merch, we will get it. And that's, it's just the waiting game. It's just the long, painful waiting game. Yeah, like, I would just love a straight up yes, no. Why did it end? Because nobody's asking Masashi Kudo, why did the Bleach anime end? And if we can get that answer, then we can see what we do to move forward. If it was straight up cancelled, then we're like, okay, maybe, you know, there's not a point. If it's on a hiatus, all we have to do is wait. If it just straight up ended, then I guess Periot don't have any, you know, goals to bring it back. But either way, this video is to tell you guys that maybe there is something else, and to bring discussion. I'm not trying to get you guys hyped up, I just want to create a discussion with you guys. What do you think Masashi Kudo means? Do you think it means that there's an anime coming back? Do you think that the waiting game is fucking real? Just what are your thoughts on this interview in general? Of course, there's going to be a link in the description down below. I'm excited, but I don't want to be too excited to the point of where I'm going to get my hopes up and then get crushed back down again. Been through that too many times. Remember last time? Yeah, it was a 30-minute TV special. And half of it was Shonen Jump fucking advertisements for other series. Anyway, I'm going to catch you motherfuckers later. You guys, of course, have this fine day. Been handsome, and as always, people, peace out.